Welcome back. You're watching ED Insight. The world is round, and who knows it better than the international brands that are trying to set up shop in India. But guess what? The rich Indian is also increasingly traveling out to international destinations in search of luxury. Asha Gopalakrishnan tells you what's on the map.
34-year-old Alok Nanavati is one of the many brand-besotted Indians who want to dress up, and why even dress down in style. So when it comes to his wardrobe, Alok can quite literally go that extra mile.
Clothing and all kinds of accessories, everything, I tend to shop abroad first.
Alok's shopping habits are quite typical. He may check out the collections of international brands in India, but he will write his checks in favor of stores abroad. And for good reason. Stores abroad offer a wider variety at lower prices. That's perhaps why Indians comprise 25 to 30% of the daily 1 lakh odd footfalls in Siam Paragon in Bangkok.
You need to establish the fundamentals of luxury extraordinarily well in the minds of wealthy consumers in India. And obviously they're very well traveled, so they go to Paris, they go to London, and they get a sense of what true luxury is.
The truth is that the rich don't mind splurging, but they know a good deal when they see one. And so, pricing is an important aspect of their buying decisions. And that's where luxury stores in India fade in comparison to their peers abroad. For instance, apparel, watches and perfumes are cheaper in places like Singapore, Dubai and the US compared to India. India imposes a 35% import duty on luxury watches compared to 4% in Singapore and 6% in America.
If you want to sell something which is not the recent collection, you want to sell something which is a part of the old collection and you want to sell it 30% extra, obviously nobody will buy it. People do travel, they'll go to UK and then they'll buy it.
That's perhaps why not too many luxury players want to be part of the Indian market yet. According to an analysis by A.T. Kearney, only 28% luxury brands from France and Belgium are present in India, compared to 62% in China. While Italian brands in India account for 30%, luxury brands from the UK, the US and Asia range between 36 and 13%. That is in sharp contrast to China. One of the biggest reasons for that is sky-high royalty prices and low footfalls.
Prime locations like Khan Market in Delhi, or indeed Breach Candy and Linking Road and Kolaba Causeway, or Kala Ghoda, in Bombay, they all are very strategic locations. The opportunity there is very limited, and therefore the cost goes up.
India is trying hard to bridge that price gap through duty-free stores at its airports. In these stores, one can easily save up to 50% on popular goods like tobacco and liquor. But the Indian duty-free stores are not a patch on the stores in Bangkok's Suvarnabhumi Airport and Singapore's Changi Airport.
By and large, you're still getting a price advantage in almost all duty-free stores. And in some stores where the operators will pay the duties for you, so it's a duty-paid operation, you're still getting a wider variety of luxury goods and products than you might find in some domestic locations. And I think that's particularly true for travelers from India.
From variety and price to prestige, a lot of shopping abroad has to do with the perception that Indian merchandise is of a poorer quality and is out of fashion. Some Indian buyers say that luxury brands offer stock of the last season in their Indian stores compared to outlets in Milan or Paris.
What they see in India is not the latest, but possibly a few seasons old. So while most luxury brand CEOs would strongly refute this, it's difficult to break the consumer mindset. And consumers do tend to believe that there's more, if I may say, in terms of value in shopping abroad.
That perception has often been misinterpreted, and dealers have walked away from partnerships on account of poor sales. For instance, in 2007, the Murjani Group gave up its exclusive dealership for Jimmy Choo and Gucci in India. That obviously did not affect the two brands much because they came back with new partners.
The moral of the story is that despite all loose ends, the luxury segment in India cannot be written off. It is a market that is expected to grow threefold and touch $14.5 billion over the next 5 years. And luxury brands are better off roughing it out now than missing the party altogether.
Well, that's all on this edition of ED Insight. We'll be back next week. But until then, thanks so much for watching.